Let's take a user table with basic user information and split the rows and blocks separately. This is called horizontal partitioning or sharding. Sharding allows us to scale along with the data and traffic growth. A shard can be a logically separate store on a separate disk, or a separate machine altogether. In our example, we'll have the shards in different hard disks. We'll need a router and a config server which encapsulates the sharding algorithm and has information on how sharding was done. You can have a read key request and a write key value request, and the router decides which shards to go to perform the read and write operations. Now this whole thing can be a single database in this case. Apart from figuring out which shard to go to, for which we have a config server, there are some key goals of sharding. Now you don't want millions of requests to go to shard 1 and just one request to shard 2. For sharding to be effective, you want incoming requests to be evenly distributed across shards. Also, while adding new shards and handling shard failures, you need to ensure that there is minimal impact to other shards and the system is still functional overall. With these key goals in mind, there are multiple design algorithms to implement sharding. The brute force design approach is to use simple hashing, where ID is the user ID or primary key, and N is the number of nodes, and M is the shard number. So if you have 10 shards, information of user ID 16 will be stored in shard 6. With this approach, everything will be fine as long as things are static. But if you have to add a new shard, you have to redistribute the data to the entire dataset. An extremely expensive operation, and it's the same problem when the shard goes down because you'll be forced to recompute your hashing and redistribute the data across shards. There is an improved approach which also includes hashing. Let's say we have server or shards from S1 to SN and user ID from U1 to let's say million. We then come up with an arbitrary fixed number line and map numeric position of each server in the number line, which can be static or dynamic using a simple hashing using modulo, and is encapsulated in the config server. We then also map the user IDs onto our number line using ID modulo P, such that some IDs will fall in the position under shard 1 and some in the position under shard 2 and so on. The remaining IDs will go back under shard 1. With a number line approach, you are decoupling data and the server. You are now agnostic of number of servers to decide which shard the user data will go to. So if you add or remove shards, you are not affecting your hashing, and so it does not result in redistribution of data that we saw in simple hashing. A better visualization would be a circle, where IDs falling in this region will be served by X1, IDs falling in this region will be served by X2 and so on. This technique is consistent hashing, but this is not a full solution yet. If a shard X3 goes down, we won't be able to serve the request between X2 and X3, for which we must replicate. Anything owned by X3 shard sector is replicated in X4 shard sector. So if user ID 16 is in X3, it will be replicated in X4 sector. If X3 goes down, X4 can take over, and similarly with other shards. The probability of two adjacent shards going down is extremely less. When you add new shards, say X4, before you bring up X4, you need to set up the replication from X3 to X4 and X4 to XN. Once all the data is seeded, X4 can start serving like any other shards. No other shard sectors are impacted. Much easier to add or remove shards.